In about 6 months ago, I uploaded this video where I changed the CPU on that workstation over there from 39X Ryzen processor, which is a 12-core processor, to this one over here, which is a 16-core 3950X processor. It's the highest processor you can get on a Ryzen AM4 socket. It's about 50% more expensive processor coming from 3900X, and quite a bit of a price jump from £400 to £650. Now the question is, was it worth it? What's the editing like when using the more expensive processor? So if you're thinking about doing the same upgrade and you're wondering, is it worth it? Should I do it? What is going to be the actual hands-on difference? What will it feel like? Is it actually faster? So in this video, I'm going to share you my experience on the 3950X processor coming from an editor's perspective. If you want to be up to date with everything that I'm talking about over here and where's the journeys come from and what we built over here, is that we built this over there, which is a really powerful PC, MacBook killer, for like a third of the price and things like that. So if you want to see all the build videos, benchmarks and what parts to use, then I'll leave them videos all linked below, as well as all the parts that I'm talking about in this video. You'll find them all in the description. Basically just dig in there and you'll find some more cool stuff. Let's start with a little bit of a reference spec. Okay, we have a 3900X and 3950X, 12-core 24-thread processor and 16-core 32-thread processor. What are the differences actually? So the base clock on the 3900X is 3.8 gigahertz, whereas on the 3950X it is 3.5 gigahertz. So on the more core processor, we're dropping 300 megahertz on the clock speed of the base speed. And then the boost on the 3900X is 4.6, sorry. And then on the 3950X, it is 4.7, so 100 megahertz higher on the 3950X. In terms of the cache, there's 2 more megabytes on the 3950X at 72 megabytes and 70 megabytes on the 3900X. Both of them have 105 watt rated TDP, and the 3900X comes with a cooler, whereas on the 3950X you're gonna have to buy a cooler for yourself. Going on from there, on the paper, let's see some of the benchmarks, what we can see on the paper over here. Cinebench R20 single and multi-core scores. So the 3900X scores single score at 476, whereas the 3950X is 510 on single score, which is roughly about 7% better. Whereas on the multi-core, we have 7,027 on the 3900X and then over 9,000 on the 3950X, which is a little bit of a more lead on the 3950X, where the multi-threaded performance is more than 7%, as you can see. First of all, I want to talk about the editing playback experience. Is it better on the playback or not? So this part of like editing process, or what it feels like editing, is I think probably the best or the most important thing that you can think of, because if your editing is choppy but your rendering is really fast, it's not really a good, you know, editing PC. But if your editing is very smooth but the rendering is slow, you can work with that, if that makes sense. So the editing performance in terms of like just like user experience, what it's been like, is that you can feel the difference. It's a little bit faster and a little bit more powerful, and I'm editing like a 4K 8-bit Sony codec, which is quite like clunky codec, but on a 4K multicam timeline, I can see how the 3950X was a little bit faster and a little bit smoother than the 3900X. Now, it's not something major, but I did feel the smoothness. You can feel the difference, but it's not something that is absolutely drastically different. So would it be worth it for just the timeline performance itself, or timeline, you know, performance spec on itself? And no, if you're just looking for a really much better timeline experience, then I don't think it's worth the money. If you're just going for that timeline performance, if you want a really good timeline performance, then Intel, unfortunately or fortunately, is still better at doing that. So Intel processor have a better playback speed on the timeline. Obviously it depends on the codec, but maybe we're talking about just mirrorless and H.264 and 265 codecs over here, then Intel is better at doing that than AMD. we're talking about like the Ryzen processors, not Threadrippers. Threadrippers are another league. But not too much about Intel and their timeline performance. That's another topic for another day. Let's talk about rendering. So when we talk about rendering between these two processors, then the 3950X jumps ahead quite a bit. I can see up to about 30% faster rendering speeds than on the 3900X. Obviously depends on the codecs and what you're doing and things like that, but if you're using purely CPU rendering and software encoding when exporting from Premiere Pro, the 3950X jumps ahead quite a bit. It's much faster doing that. I did like my own little test project and exported them from both systems, and I could see about going from 10 minutes, which was on the 3900X, to about 7 minutes or something, just over 7 minutes on the 3950X, which is quite a big of a jump. But bear in mind, since the Premiere Pro 14.2 release, where GPU or hardware encoding or acceleration is enabled or possible, and more GPU is being utilized, the numbers might not be as equal, or they will be more equal and there won't be as much off, because the CPU matters a bit less when it's on the GPU encoding. Now bear in mind, not everything can be encoded on the GPU, and if you still need a lot of CPU power, you know, when you're doing a two-pass export, for example, then this is only possible at this point still only on the software encoding, which means only CPU will be utilized. Maybe a little bit of GPU, but not as much as we'd like. So if you're thinking about rendering, and rendering is one of your biggest things about changing to this processor, then this is definitely worth it. I can see a big jump on the rendering side, or the rendering aspect of this. It is fantastic. So next of all is like the rest of the everyday tasks, and maybe if you're doing a little bit of Photoshop or Lightroom and all of this editing, then this is very good as well. I think you can feel it a little bit more snappier because the single core performance is a little bit faster, so everything feels a slightly faster. But you know, I'm trying not to make this in my head and not actually imagine it, but actually feel it. But it's really hard to tell the difference. If you're really putting them side to side, then there's not that big of a difference. But at the same time, the 3950X is a little bit faster, if you know what I mean. All the rest of the things that, you know, maybe just utilizes single core performance or single thread performance, then the 3950X is slightly faster as well. But it's not magnificently faster, something that you would see a drastic difference, okay? And then now the last aspect, what I want to talk about is the thermals, because the 3950X does not come with a cooler. On the website they say liquid cooler is recommended, and you know, you have to pay extra for the liquid cooler or the cooler that you're gonna get, because 3900X comes with a cooler already in. So you could use the stock cooler, which is very adequate doing the job, or get a better one, but you're gonna pay extra. So in terms of the price difference, grows even more when you have to buy the external or the extra cooler that the 3950X doesn't come with. But how does that Noctua NHD15 handle the Ryzen 3950X? And it handles it absolutely beautifully. Honestly, I haven't had any issues with like the thermals and things like that. It's just, you know, running a render there at the moment, depends obviously on the room temperature, because that can affect it a lot. But if it's normal around 20 degrees Celsius around there, it just runs about 60, 70, something like that. And I've got the core temp often open over there to see like the highs and mins. And today it's been running for what, about 6 hours, maybe something like that, and the max temp it's reached over that 6 hours is 72°C, which is amazing temperatures. Now I did have a little bit of a bug over there, and I'm not sure what caused that over there, and if someone wants to let me know in the comment section below, I'd love to know if you know would or would suggest what the answer would be here. But after changing from 3900X to 3950X, I realized now, after, because I've just recently repasted my CPU over there, I realized that there was some kind of like a residue, or some kind of, I don't think the contact was very good on it. So my thermals were constantly high, and was like, what's going on? But that was after I installed the 3950X. So I think that was the error of my installation of the cooler, but it was still like working fine. You know, I edited probably around 50, 60, 100 videos on it, and there was no problem with it. Now, what I did see though was a software bug, which I have no idea how did that happen, or how did that happen after the CPU upgrade. So basically what happened is there was something inside the computer that killed the fan speeds on the cases and on the CPU cooler. So basically, I realized that after it's been to sleep and come back to the computer, that was more often when it happened, or sometimes even just without being asleep, just randomly, the fans just would stop working. The fans wouldn't ramp up when the temperature would heat up. So I could see that the temperature is higher, for example. So if I went on Creator Center, the MSI program that comes with this motherboard, you could see that the temperature is higher and the fans should be running at that point, but the fans are just idling, maybe just like base speed or very, very low speed, and that was on everything. And then it was a few times where I'd come in and I'd see just like, oh, what's going on? It feels very like slow. And I put the core temp on and I see like 100 degrees, and I was like, whoa, what's going on? And then I'd manually go on the, you know, Creator Center, whatever, how I would do it is just manually kick every single fan up 100% speed, and then it would calm down. But it was weird that you have to like kind of manually start to overwrite it, and I have no idea what caused this. So since then I've wiped the windows and put it back on, and now there doesn't seem to be any issues with it. I'm suspecting it could be the Creator Center, but I don't know. If any of you know this, please let me know in the comment section below. And at the first time when we installed the 3900X, there was no problems as such. So to conclude, the thermals are absolutely fine with even some of the beefier air coolers. So if you want to go with them, you completely can, and it can handle the rendering and all that stuff perfectly. Is it worth then to get this 3950X over the 3900X? In my experience and in my case, it has been worth it, because the amount of money I've spent over on it actually relates to me creating and finishing jobs much faster. The little bit of the timeline performance and the rendering speeds, it renders sometimes a few videos every single day, and when it renders, you can do editing, but it's much choppier than doing the renderings separately. So all of these things add up that make it worth it for me, you know, from in my case. I'm not sure if you are in the same case, but in my case, I think it was worth that extra little bit of the jump that would give me the performance. Now, this is like the maximum that I could upgrade until I reach the Threadripper threshold, and I have to change the complete system up, so I'm not ready to cash that much out yet and don't have that finances yet. But basically this is like the little jump that would give me a little bit of an improvement when using this processor. Is it the best bang for buck in terms of editing? No, not really. If you're really on a budget and you're looking for the best bang for buck, definitely stay with the 3900X, not the 3900XT. That's like 50 more expensive. The 3900X is the way to go. But the every minute and every little second that I get the renderings faster and the timeline performance smoother, that just is a big thumbs up from me, and that's why it has been worth it. So hopefully this was helpful for you to kind of know whether this was worth it for you, or would it be worth it for you, explaining your case. If you want to know like what I'm doing, then quickly, I'm doing lots of content creation on YouTube now mainly, so a lot of YouTube videos, that's why I'm using this editing machine for. So let me know what you think in the comment section below. I'd love to know from you. I'd love to hear from you if you're on the same dilemma or if you're on the same decision. And hit that like button, it actually makes different. Subscribe if you haven't already, and I'll see you in the next one. Adios.